Fijian professional boxer Winston Hill has been officially called out by a street fighter in Nadonumai, and Mr. Hill actually answered the call. Usually professional fighters, they don't bring themselves down and play around with little boys who have no business in the ring, but I have to admit, it's big of Hill to actually accept the challenge of the street fighter who goes by the name of Vili. I don't know if that's his social media handle, if that's his street fighter name, or that's his real name. Either way, Mr. Hill met him at a backyard gym, I'm assuming at Nadonumai. Before we jump into the fight, break it down and react to it, I think it's only fair that we listen to Vili Vava's official challenge. Here it is.
Bulumnaka, Mr. Winston Hill, you're the champion of Fiji right now. But you know, in the way that I really need to present that way to the world. In front of me, if you accept this challenge, come to Nadonumai. Or if no, ring me. My number is 908-6285. I'm not afraid of you. Karena saya tahu nak taruh pak Winston. Rezeki mana matangku, ising lam tegi ku, ising kleo. Iku turut cuma nembel je, bina kata mana matak. Ibu kau kau bapa anjing cinta kan ku ising rabi ku, data kau mana ising mendarat darum begina. Ambil iku, iku nak taruh pak. Sekarang kau tangku bahasa. Pak anjing cinta kau orang kau rokobi ku tumbe tegi ku champion jung. Offer, accept tang mana offer ku. Darat darum begina nak taruh pak. Anu mina kasar cikku Winston. Dar nada rumbi iko nada romba, ronga dana bosa.
So I don't know what happened in between. I don't know if messages were exchanged, but Vili gave his phone number, and I think Hill and his team must have got in contact with Vili and his team, and they met and they sorted it out. I don't know if there's any issues, if there's any beef, or if Vili just wanted a shot at the title, but he definitely got his shot. So let's look at the fight and see what happened.
Winston and Vili from Nadonumai having a good sparring session. Vili said that he wants to challenge Winston, so they're having a good sparring session. One and a half minute to go. Let's go. 30 seconds to go. 15 seconds. Time.
Okay, so it seemed like basic 3 minutes, one round, some sort of backyard gym. Vili started off pretty strong, and I mean, judging him as a street fighter, in the opening first 10 to 15 seconds, he got too excited, he was over enthusiastically trying to bring down Mr. Hill. But then Hill has been in the game for a while, and one of the other fighters tried to drown him, but ended up drowning in shallow waters just the fight before.
When you jump in with Cheshire, it's a different story. Inside the ring, it's a different story. Here, it's a different story. I'll take him to deep waters, then I'll drown you.
So Hill knew what he was doing. 3 minutes is a long time. And Vili depleted his energy and outpunched himself within the first few seconds. What happened next was Vili was running around. That's the strategy if you're trying to fight a big guy like Andy Ruiz, you try and tire them out. But it doesn't seem like that there's a lot of fat on Hill. So he followed him all the way around until Vili eventually tripped over his own gym set and fell down. Maybe he didn't memorize the steps well enough, maybe he didn't know it was there, but this is an important lesson for Vili. Now he knows to be careful what you ask for, because you just might get it.
Looks like you got exactly what you wanted!
As for Mr. Hill, he is now the official gatekeeper of professional boxing in Fiji. There's been a number of gatekeepers in the past. Some notable ones is Mike Tyson, when he was challenged by the gangster Tyson Fury and his upcoming fight with Ngannou, the MMA fighter. So MMA, Ngannou fights in the octagon, and now he's making the transition to come into the boxing ring. Tyson Fury is gonna serve and act as the gatekeeper. Another popular one is Mayweather. Yeah, Mayweather and Conor McGregor. Logan Paul actually slipped through the gate in a very rare case and is trying to make his name in boxing. Now, Logan Paul's biggest mistake is trying to call out Canelo Alvarez. Man, Canelo he's in a whole different level. This guy in the class that he has in terms of skill and professionalism, he is a beast. He's actually mastered the beautiful art of boxing. True, he lost Mayweather, but he's learned from it, and he tamed the lion, Charlo, and now he's looking for more bigger fights in the future. When a reporter once asked Canelo if he ever considered taking a fight with, I think, was it Logan Paul? Oh, no, not Logan Paul, sorry. It was Conor McGregor. Canelo basically laughed it off and said, he doesn't want to bring himself down. He's got bigger plans than that. Now, the thing with these type of fighters, when they want to fight, when people with no business in the ring actually want to step into the ring and fight, what happens is they receive a lot of popularity, and this is their, 15 minutes of fame, and they have a huge payday after. So it's easy to call them out, but then it just degrades the hard work that's been put in, the sacrifice that's been made, the training, everything that brings these fighters to such an elite level. You're just basically wiping all that away and saying, yeah, I can fight you, I want to be at the same level you are. So for Hill to actually come down, go to the guy's gym in Nadonumai and fight him, beat him, and not even try to knock him out, it seemed like Hill was showing a lot of restraint. He didn't want to knock him out, he just wanted to teach him a lesson and then leave. So hats off to you, Hill. And a fun fact about Hill, he's actually a product of the GAPS program. Now, GAPS is Gather, Adjust, Prepare, and Sustain. It's a program offered by Griffith University. And aside from Winston Hill, You have the beach volleyball girls from Vanuatu. They came from the GAPS program as well. And the current program is being redesigned to offer more for Pacific Island athletes. If you're an athlete and looking for other ways to try and improve on your discipline, your chosen field of sport, you can try and apply for these scholarships that's been offered by Griffith University. There's been a lot of athletes who've gone through, and currently for 2023, there is one athlete who got a scholarship that's academic and also training for a few years. Now, if you want to read the full story, the link is in the description below. It's a story I wrote for Vanuatu Daily Post, and you can find out how you can apply for these scholarships if you go onto the Griffith website. Anyways, bringing it back to boxing, Hill and Vili Dava. Mr. Dava, someone had to take the bullet, and you, unfortunately, are the fall guy. If you didn't call out Hill, someone would have called him out eventually in the future. So someone had to take the bullet, and in this case, it's you. So while you did embarrass yourself, it's also a teaching moment, not just for you, but for the country, that the reason why these people are at their elite level in this particular discipline isn't because they've been watching boxing and they've decided that they can be at that level. No, those belts aren't available at the belt shop. He actually earned that, and it took a lot of sacrifice and a lot of hard work and a lot of training. These fighters, they are very specific with their punches. They know where the liver shot is, the kidney shot. They know where to hurt you. And as a street fighter, you probably went in, I'm sure you have an impressive resume as a Nadonumai street fighter, and you must have made a name for yourself throughout the streets of Suva City. But you have no business in the ring. And now that you've been taught a lesson, and if you want to further your career in boxing as an apprentice, I think you should reach out to Mr. Hill and ask him if you could help you with your sparring. Maybe you could offer your sparring services for free, and next year you could eventually apply for the Griffith scholarship, and maybe you might get that opportunity. So I know in Fiji a lot of people are focused on rugby. In Vanuatu, a lot of youngsters are focused on football, but there's also other opportunities available, and that's offered by our foreign partners, Australia, New Zealand, China. They're coming in strong with a lot of scholarships as well to assist us with our development in terms of career path that we've chosen, the discipline that we've chosen when it comes to sports. And also they throw in free Mandarin, so it's a win-win.